Okay, this is part one. This is my personal story. I wrote a book about this story based on true events that happened to me. I might get emotional, I might cry, I might reflect, I might pause, I might have a flashback. Who knows? But I'm going to go through and tell you my personal account of what happened and the book that I wrote, this, The Pursuit of Happiness After a Divorce, which has resources and tools for you to get the support you need to get through the chaotic events of life and relationships. So hopefully some of these tools in here, and at the back of the book, I have references and resources that you can read to help set boundaries and other things that you need to do in your life. So how we met 5 years ago. I'm going to say 5 years ago because it's way longer than that. When I was 20, I started my first job at a customer service place. I got a temp job doing customer service. When I did this customer service, it's cold here in Florida. When I started customer service, I started for a long customer service job, right? I had been there for about a week, and the person who trained me was my ex-husband. So I met him. I was introduced to him saying, hey, this is this person, Caleb. He's going to train you. And I'm like, oh, sweet, cool. He was very social, very talkative, very outgoing, very good at sales. He had the number one sales there at the company. Everyone liked him. Just a really social, charismatic personality. Very talkative, attractive, tall. I thought he was handsome. So we had been talking, and then he'd been training me, and then he got my phone number, and he'd been talking to me at night, and after work, before work, we went out to lunch at work. He bought me lunch, which was really nice and sweet. And he was just like a great person to be around. He was hilarious. He was funny. We talked. He made me laugh. And it was just like a great personality. All consuming. Just personality. Talkative. Constant attention. And we met. We hung out. We talked. Like hang out. I think the first week I went and met his people. His family and stuff like that. His daughters. The first week we hung out together. But just constantly around each other and stuff like that. Then my car had broke down, and come to find out this man had lived in the same apartment complex. I mean, two buildings down. I could look out my apartment and look and see him. That's how close he was to me. So at work every day and at home, he was right around the corner, like engulfed. So I had been single for that time period, and I had been celibate for almost like 2 years. I think my daughter was almost going on two, one and a half, something like that. So I did not have any attention or affection or any type of stuff, and I was isolated. Before I was in a relationship, I was heavily in the church every day. I'm talking about every day, church, God, that's it. Like, that was my life. Raising my daughter, church, work, that was it. I was in a relationship there at the church, and I was really hurt when we broke up because I really felt like me and that person would be together. It didn't work out. I know obviously why the person that he's with, he is meant to be with, like, it's perfect fit for him. And that relationship didn't work out. And that's fine. Things don't work out. But I was heartbroken after that. And about 6 months later, I ran into Caleb, the new dude. 11 years of Caleb. And it's just like, when I met him, sure, like, I feel like he was a Superman. My car had broke down. He helped me get to work. He helped me take my daughter to daycare and then go to work so I could keep that job. He trained me on a job. He was really nice. He said such nice things about me that, like, I was pretty, I was beautiful, I was like a goddess. And I had been celibate at the time and saving myself for marriage. I put all my guards down, constantly talking to this dude and being with him. Then I became intimate with him quickly. And then after that, just intoxicated, it was over. It was like I was wrapped and done. Like, I think if I would have waited, I would have left a lot longer. Dude. But after you had sex, the seal of the deal was over. Just starstruck. But yeah. Please learn from my story. Please learn from my experiences. Please learn from the red flags that I tell you about. Tons of love bombing. Just beautiful attention, attraction, love bombing in the beginning. And I really feel like some of it's true and genuine. I really feel like he was a genuine person at the time when I met him. And he was what I needed him to be at the time. And I was just really introvert at the time, and he was super extrovert and super social, that our personalities were way different, where I'm just like starstruck. So I was with this dude for 11 years, man. Wow. Wow. He was popular. I was not popular. Just the wind's blowing the whole way. Yeah, sorry about the wind feedback. I can't control nature. This is like my 10th retake of doing this. There's always been something to interrupt. about, but I'm going to tell my story. I've been scared to tell my story for years, actually tell it, just because it's a lot, but I'm going to do it. I'm going to tell my story. I'm telling my story. Lifetime. No. But, yeah, you know, my self-worth was really low at the time. My self-esteem was really low. I didn't have any attention. I didn't have a support group. I was isolated. I don't like being isolated. I'm an introvert. But you still need to have that feedback around the people you surround yourself with. Jacksonville. That's what's... Woo-woo! Anyway, so going into it, we had been talking. This and that happened. He was my superhero when I meet him. I felt like he was the ideal partner for me and my family. Jacksonville. All day, every day. That's what you're going to hear. Then, listen, we went out to a bar. I went to go meet up with my sister and her dude at the time. So we went out to the bar, and this is the first time my sister met him. I went to the bathroom while we're at the bar. He seemed pretty cool with my family and stuff like that. I'm like, oh, sweet, let me go to the restroom. I went to the restroom and came back out. My sister pulled me aside. It's windy, but y'all gotta listen up here because I'm telling my story today. No wind, no siren, no nothing gonna stop me from telling the story. I'm telling it. If you want to read the book, it's on Audible, Amazon. Go to Amazon.com, The Pursuit of Happiness After Divorce. You can read the book, download it, read the ebook, listen to it. It's on Spotify. It's there. It's out there. It's been out there for years. I just haven't really told it like this. So I'm telling it like this. This is what it is. Okay. So, first red flag. First red flag. You go to the bar. He meets my sister. Meets my family. I don't care when. I'm going to tell my story anyway. Meets my family. My sister. Only my sister and her dude. I go to the restroom. Come back out. My sister tells me, hey, you need to go to the bar. And I'm like, what's going on to the bar? So he's at the bar, right? Talking to the bartender. The bartender. Yeah. I go up to him. She knows that he's flirting with another girl, right? And she's like, why? What's going on with him? He's not a good dude for you. Like, I can clearly see he's not a good dude. He has, like, no respect for you, right? And I'm like, no, it's cool, it's cool. I go up to him, why he's flirting with the other girl at the bar. And I go up to him and say, hey. He ignores me like I'm not, like I don't exist. Ignores me. Now, this is the dude that's been talking to me every single day, like acknowledging me, everything in public, this and that, to immediately we're in a private situation in his city where he ignores me in front of my family, my sister. And tell me what I do. Nothing. Nothing at all. I accept it. And I make excuses for myself. And I say, well, we're not really exclusive. We're not even in a relationship. But we talking like it. We acting like it. We dealing like it. And that was the first red flag where I was held on a dream of being in a relationship with this dude. Because he was different than any other dude I've been with. Same story. Different dude. And I wanted the relationship to work, and I wanted to be married to this dude. He had already told me he had to picture me in a white dress. He already told me that I was like his wife, and yeah, that's when I should have left. Now, this is 3 months into meeting him. I think 2 months into meeting him, and I stayed, and then we moved in 4 months later. We were together for 4 months when he moved in to my place. We're going to talk more about that in part two. Mm-hmm. Yeah, so I stayed. First red flag, I stayed, I overlooked it, and I made excuses for myself because my self-esteem was low, because the rejection of my self-worth was low, because I didn't want to be alone. I hope y'all please listen to what I'm saying. Please learn from my experiences. I got a lot of mistakes. I got a lot of stupid mistakes that y'all can learn from. Please, I hope y'all learn from me. That's when I should have left. I should have left. Then I could have saved myself heartbreak. But no, I stayed. Stayed for 11 years. 11. 11. 11. 11. Okay. I laugh about it now, but it was really painful. You know. So, stay tuned for part 2.